'Tis the season to be greedy. If you have been keeping up with Destiny 2 news, then you know that there has been a lot of sketchy shit going on with this game in the short 3 months that it's been out. It is no secret that Bungie and Activision have been subject to relentless backlash due to numerous underhanded schemes and broken features that have all but tarnished what could have been a potentially great game. But even after all that's happened, nothing could prepare me for the unprecedented level of avarice that would take shape in the form of Destiny 2's Dawning event. For those who don't know what Dawning is, in the Destiny lore, it's basically Christmas, and on a meta level, it's an annual holiday event where they overhaul the game's visuals to be more winter-like and Christmassy, while adding some fun new features like snowball fights and a hockey arena along the way. Those who've played MMOs and other forms of constantly evolving games will be familiar with the concept of seasonal game events. They are ultimately supposed to be fun, a means for game developers to thank their players, and a time for the community to come together in celebration. But Bungie and Activision, being the greedy fucks they are, decided that instead of making Dawning about a time of giving, they would turn it into a time of taking. So, here's what happened. As part of the Dawning event, Bungie added what are called Dawning Ingrams, which are loot boxes that are specifically tied to the Dawning event. Each Dawning Ingram offers 2 random rewards from a pool of 59 new Dawning exclusive items ranging from armor, emotes, ghost shells, ships, shaders, to transmat effects. Now here's where things start to get insidious. Normally, games with seasonal events will update loot boxes across the board so that they reward players with all the exclusive new stuff tied to the seasonal event. Take a game like Overwatch, for example. During their Halloween event, everyone earned Halloween loot boxes regardless of whether they earned them for free or bought them. Same thing with the Winter Wonderland event, same thing with the Chinese New Year event, so on and so forth. But Bungie decided to break tradition and take a far more devious approach with Dawning by making it so that the loot boxes you earn for free by leveling up are only the standard ones that gives you the old stuff, not the Dawning Ingrams that give you the new event items. So how do you earn free Dawning Ingrams then, you ask? Well, you can earn a maximum of 3 per week, one as a freebie, another by completing 5 Mayhem Crucible matches, and one more by completing 5 Heroic Strikes. And yes, you heard correctly, I said per week. There is a weekly hard cap on how many of these free Dawning Ingrams you can earn from doing these activities. It's also worth noting that this cap applies to your entire account, not your individual characters. So if you earned all the Dawning Ingrams as a Warlock, then switch to your Hunter and redo these activities, you'll only earn minor items like a couple shaders instead of Dawning Ingrams. You have to wait until the next week so that the cap resets. What this means is that throughout the whole event, which lasts for 3 weeks from December 19th, 2017 to January 9th, 2018, you can only earn a maximum of 9 free Dawning Ingrams total. And with each Dawning Ingram only rewarding you 2 random Dawning items, I don't think I need to explain why 9 Ingrams isn't nearly enough to earn all 59 Dawning items. Now, one more way you can earn some Dawning items is by completing daily quests provided by the NPC Ikora Rey. Completing these will grant you a reward called a Gift in Return, which is a separate loot box that contains 2 random rewards from a more limited pool of the 59 Dawning items, with a couple items being exclusive to these daily Ikora gifts. So the Ikora gifts that earn you free Dawning items daily have a limited pool of Dawning rewards, whereas the Dawning loot boxes that earn you free Dawning items weekly have the full pool of Dawning rewards, minus a couple things exclusive to the Ikora gifts. It's all very backwards when you think about it. The bottom line is this: by preventing players from earning Dawning Ingrams through level ups, and by limiting Dawning Ingram earnings to a weekly basis, they have carefully crafted the Dawning event to make it impossible to earn enough Donning Ingrams or Ikora gifts to get all of the items from the 3-week-long event. The time limit is the real kicker here. As is the way these types of events work in other games, once they are over, players will no longer be able to earn these seasonal items. Whatever items you didn't manage to get in time will be out of your reach forever. In the case of Destiny 2's Donning, with only 3 weeks to earn these 59 items, Bungie deviously ensured that the only way to get them all before they're gone for good is by spending real money to buy Donning Ingrams in bulk. And while it's true that there is still the option of purchasing Donning items by spending Bright Dust, an in-game currency that allows players to pick out and buy individual items with none of the RNG crap, items purchased through Bright Dust are so expensive that even if you grinded 24/7, it would still not be enough to obtain all the Donning items in time without buying the loot boxes. One Reddit user calculated that it costs a grand total of 32,900 Bright Dust to purchase one of every Donning item, which is an exorbitant amount. So the bottom line is that players unequivocally have to spend real money on Donning Ingrams to even have a chance of earning all the new Donning items before they're gone forever once the event expires in 3 weeks. And this is all by design. They have indirectly paywalled an entire holiday event and its various attractions. Oh, and here's something else to consider. So you know how Destiny 2 changed shaders from Destiny 1 so that they would be consumables instead of unlockables to make them more monetizable? Well, guess what? Since Donning exclusive shaders will be gone once the event is over, since you won't be able to grind for more of them anymore come January 9th, 2018, using one of these shaders means losing it forever. This wouldn't be a problem if shaders worked the way they did in Destiny 1, in which they were permanently unlocked for players to play around with at their leisure without concern of running out of them. But Bungie knows this, and they're using the threat that these consumable one-time use shaders will be gone forever after 3 weeks to strong-arm players into purchasing bulks of loot boxes and stocking up on what will become precious commodities. And speaking of shaders, one of the biggest complaints about Destiny 2 is the ridiculously small vault capacity that makes it impossible for players to store all their precious earnings. It's a ridiculous issue when you consider that Destiny 1 had a significantly bigger vault capacity. How the hell Bungie justified having the sequel regress in that regard is anyone's guess. The Donning event adds insult to the vault capacity injury by making it so that Donning exclusive shaders with the same name obtained from Ikora gifts and Donning Ingrams don't stack on top of each other for some reason. We are talking identical shaders that you get from two different sources that are treated separately for some reason, and as a result, they end up taking up an additional limited and precious vault slot. I guess the only difference between the Ikora gift shaders versus the Donning Ingram ones is that when you dismantle the gift shaders, you earn legendary shards, whereas if you dismantle the Ingram shaders, you are given a measly 7 Bright Dust, a pathetic and almost inconsequential amount when you look at how much Bright Dust purchases cost. Once again, the intention is clear. Bungie wants to nudge people towards buying loot boxes with real money, not picking out and buying individual items with in-game currency. So yeah, I mean, what else is there to say? Destiny 2's Donning event, which was supposed to be a celebration of the upcoming holidays, a commemoration of the community, and Bungie's opportunity to mend the vast rift that they formed with their player base, only turned out to be a platform for their greatest scam yet and their greediest fuck you to players, all in time for Christmas. How pathetic is it that they can't keep their avarice in check just for one goddamn festive month? How utterly disgusting is it that this is how far they're willing to go to make a quick buck on the side? The balls that these bastards have to pull shit like this in light of the Battlefront 2 loot box fiasco, and in light of all the backlash that they already received against their previous deviant intentions and schemes, is almost impressive in its stupidity. In case you forgot already, before this deplorable Donning event, Bungie and Activision were caught secretly throttling XP and doubling XP requirements. They were caught locking old content behind the new and underwhelming Curse of Osiris DLC. They were recently caught with their pants down implementing malfunctioning features like Three of Coins exotic drop rate boosters and the Faded Ingrams, and the list just goes on and on. How did they respond each time? They released the same hollow, apologetic statement about how they'll look into it, how things aren't working as they intended, how it was an accident and a mistake, and how they'll improve and be more transparent moving forward. Each time it was after they got caught red-handed. Everything was working as intended until they got busted. And each time, nothing ever changed, did it? It's always the same old song and dance. In my eyes, Bungie, Activision, and Destiny 2 are irredeemable at this point. It's not just about the blatant, unflinching, deceitful greed, it's also about the kind of message that they're sending by pulling shit like this during festivities. They are like a Grinch that cannot be vindicated. They are the Bungie who stole Dawning. Even EA has the sense to wait until the holidays pass before they fuck over Battlefront 2 players by relaunching microtransactions. And no, that isn't a compliment to EA, fuck EA. But Bungie really stooped to a new low and they have now dug themselves in a deep hole that they're gonna really struggle to get out of. Get ready, Bungie and Activision, because there is PR hell to pay. Major gaming websites are already picking up on this story, and the community backlash has been swift, merciless, and decisive. For anyone who is still playing Destiny 2 after this, now would be a great time to quit while you're ahead. Because it's pretty clear by now that at every turn, Destiny 2 has taken a step back from its predecessor, regressing features to make them more monetizable at the expense of the player experience, all a part of Bungie's quest to feed their Eververse marketplace, an ever-growing and evolving monstrosity around which the game is steadily being built around inch by inch right under our noses. We're starting to see items that affect gameplay like ghost shells that provide a variety of buffs or compelling armor pieces trickle into the Eververse, foreshadowing the kind of future that Bungie and Activision are aiming for. Don't just take my word for it, Bungie is literally hiring a senior progression manager whose job would be to build and maintain the Eververse as well as design a progression system that revolves around Ingrams. I don't know about you, but with all said and done, Destiny 2 sounds like it is headed straight for a shitty future. And after all that's happened, even the most dedicated players should ask themselves if it's a future that they want to be a part of. Let's usher a new year and a new golden age together, says Bungie. Fuck you. With that, I would like to end this news update and discussion video. Thank you for tuning in. I hope you found this video enlightening, and if you enjoy my content, consider supporting me on Patreon to help this channel stay independent and self-sustained. And to be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out.